of God. You would rather me with a melody. Hey. You surround me with a song. My deliverer,
hey,
from my enemy.
And somebody shout a praise in the house. Somebody shout a hallelujah praise in the house. Somebody shout a hallelujah praise in the house. Hey, hallelujah. Somebody shout a praise in the house. Somebody shout a praise. Hallelujah. Hey. Oh, 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 yeah. 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 There's a sweet anointing in this place tonight. Hallelujah. Jesus, can we just worship him for a minute? Can we just take a minute and just give him some praise tonight? Oh God, you are worthy. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. We exalt your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah, Jesus. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. Hey, we lift you up. We lift you up. We magnify you. You tonight. We thank you tonight, God. We thank you. We thank you. From the bottom of our hearts, we worship you. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, God. Move in this place tonight, God. Jesus, hallelujah. Hey, mighty God, we serve a great, big, wonderful God. Jesus can move any mountain. Hallelujah. Ah, God, Jesus, what a God, what a God, what a God, what a God. Jesus, come on, give him some praise. Is there another praise in the house? Is there another praise in the house? Is there a yet praise in the house? Yes, I might be here tonight and I might be going through some situation. Hey, God. And I might be praying and praying and praying over and over again. And it seems like nothing is going on. And the pastor says that, God, why? Why, me Lord? Sometimes we might come to church and we don't feel like worship. But what about our yet praise? Hey, hey, hey. What about our yet praise? I don't feel like worship, but yet I have a praise. Ghost! Holy Ghost! Holy Ghost! Jesus! Jesus! I could have been dead so many times. Oh God! I remember I asked God, why? Why me, Lord? Why? I remember I cried, I prayed and I fasted and I cried. Jesus. And I prayed and I cried. And I said, God, I don't want to die, leave my children. Because if I die, what would happen to my children? Not even the husband, but my children. Hey, God. I know what would happen to them. I would know that would tear them apart. I remember come out on my veranda one morning to do some laundry. Hallelujah. And I just feel a feeling start to take over my body. I don't know what happened next. One sister, because it was a Saturday morning, one Adventist Christian was going down the road to church. That's how I hear the story, because I did not know what happened. As she saw me fell down, lying down on the step. The step is a high step. And the step is like this. And the ground is down there. And my head hung over. Jesus. And the girl said, she was calling, Precious. Precious. No answer. Precious. No answer. And when she realized that there was no answer, she run over. And when she hold me, I was not moving. And she called the other rest of the family that live in the yard. And my auntie-in-law, topside there. And they came down. And they started to pray. When I come back, I found myself sitting down on the veranda, a chair, and everybody around me. And I was like, what is going on? What's wrong? And they started to tell me what's happened. I was there foaming fart. Echo shatter. They told me that my eyes rolling over. Foaming prey fart coming to my mouth. Only the breath was coming out, but I was dead. My body was dead. Jesus. And they prayed for me. When my husband took me to the doctor, they said I had a seizure attack. And that attacked me for 2 years straight. When I went back to the dock one night, I was in my bed and I fell off the bed. I don't know how I fell off. But when I come back to my son, had me in his hand, praying and rebuking and cursing, and my husband was there just crying. But here I am tonight. Brethren, you see when me come into the house of God, I don't come to play. I come to worship. Because when I remember what happened to me, I could have been dead so many times. I could not go nowhere by myself. One of my siblings have to follow me. Doctor said I must not leave the house. I must not go nowhere by myself. And I promise that anywhere I go, I will share this testimony. I remember I was going to the hospital at Falmouth. And my daughter was there with me in the taxi. And the taxi was driving. And I started to pull the door. I did not know what I was doing. I started to open the taxi door. And I only felt when my daughter grabbed my hand and said, Mommy, what you doing? I did not know what she's talking about, as I don't know nothing. If my daughter wasn't there in the taxi with me, I would have fell out the car, because the driver did not know what's going on behind him. I would have opened the car and get out. And maybe I would had a car would come and crush me. But thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. I have proven him over and over again that he is a healer. And he is real. He's real. And he's a healer. Here I am tonight. Here I am tonight. I'm giving God thanks for his healing. Glory to God. Jesus. You see the best of me now. Hallelujah. And I'm giving God thanks tonight. Just stand with me and just shout a praise. Hallelujah. While I hand over the rest of the service to a elder. Elder Stroh. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Glory. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Thank you. What a great God we serve. What a great God he is. Said angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a God. Come on, look at somebody and say, what a God. I don't look like you know, keep malice with each other, some man. Look at the prayer. What a God. Mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God, mighty God. I am quite sure everyone inside here has a testimony. So somebody said, when I think of the goodness and all my soul, you don't have to tell me to worship God. My soul is good. The very thought that God has been so good to me makes my soul cries out. Praise God. You may be seated. We realize that we are running against time. And we have folks here from Montego Bay. And they might stay here the rest of night with us tonight. Amen. That would be good. Praise God. But I do understand. Amen. Praise God. I just want to thank God for you and especially you. It's a wonderful thing to know that you are here and made the sacrifice to be here. You're looking so beautiful down there. Amen. Praise God. And we want to thank God for all our ministers. Praise God who have taken the time off. Praise God making the sacrifice to be here with us tonight. And I really appreciate you wherever you are from. Amen. Praise God. I might miss out one or two persons, but I want to say to everybody, you're all welcome. And seeing that I may not do a good job of it, just turn to somebody beside you and just said, welcome. And I'm so happy to have you here with us tonight. So if me not bother welcome on, no can't say nothing, right? Amen? Anyway, praise God. We are glad and happy to have you with us and worshiping with us tonight. We have Deacon Bowman and saints from Rocky Point. Praise God. Good God. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. And we have two set of people from Rocky Point here tonight. You know? And you know the beauty about it? I'm father for both of them. Praise God. Nevertheless, we have Pastor Malcolm, praise God, Mother Adams in the house also, and saints from Grace Christ Temple Apostolic. Praise God. Glory to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm so glad and happy to see them another time. Praise God. Glad and happy to know that you can be here tonight with us again. Amen. Praise God. They were here on Friday night. Am I right? Praise God. Praise God. Glad and happy to see you again, Brother Mark. Amen. Praise God. And we have also with us, praise God, Evangelist Douglas and wife from Lighthouse, the Pentecost, Cementville. Praise God. God bless you, sir. Glad and happy to have you with us. You see, the problem with this brother, I'm always having a problem with him over the years, because they are twins, and I don't know which one is which one. If no, praise God. But I'm glad and happy to have you with us tonight. They are my friends. Amen? Praise God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We have also, praise God, we have Pastor, praise God. Okay, we have Pastor Jones and Saints from Faith United, praise God, Longsdale Park. Pastor Jones. Okay, and Saints, okay. Praise God, because I was wondering. Praise God, amen. Come on, just shout a praise. God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, Sister Donna and brother. God bless you, God bless you. Glad and happy to see you again, amen. Praise God. We are reconnecting, amen. We are reconnecting, believe it or not, amen. And tonight we have also Pastor McNeil and Saints from Pentecostal Tabernacle, Suttons. Praise God. Originally out of Rocky Point also. Amen, everybody. Praise God. Amen. Yes, he's an original Christ gospel man. Amen, everybody. So we are reconnecting. Amen. Praise God. And we have, as usual with us, Pastor Howitt and Saints from Bailey's Avenue. Praise God. Glory to God. Praise God. And I'm going to be asking all the pastors and overseers, someone, praise God, and all the saints from Christ's gospel to stand and shout a praise. Now, most of you over there, so many of you don't stand up if you know other church, you know. So we can't understand how you still sit down. Amen. Come on, shout a praise. Come on, shout another praise. Praise God, praise God. And we have members from this community, praise God, which we want to really put our hands together for the members of this community. Just wave your hands and give the Lord a praise. Praise God, praise God. We're glad and happy. Praise God to have you. Praise God. Glory to God. God bless you, Sister O'Neill, on the outside there. Praise God. God bless you. God bless you. Glad and happy to see you and others. Praise God. Coming in. Did I miss out anyone? Praise God. Amen. Praise God. So I'm glad and happy to have you. Our musicians. Praise God. God bless you. God bless you, Brother Ryan. God bless you, sir. Praise God. Eh? Yeah, UPC. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. I just want to do something quickly here before the word of God is coming. Amen. But I just want to say to us that we have started from Friday morning. Amen. And God has been so good to us. So far we have, praise God, one being baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Two persons have been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. And one of them got the Holy Ghost last night. Praise God. Praise God. And we have backsliders return as well. So God has been good to us. And we have tonight. Amen. So I am quite sure that there are souls here to be born again. Souls here to be filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. Amen. And I only hope that you come, praise God, expecting a miracle. Amen, everybody? Amen, everybody? I'm not hearing much from that side over there. You are so quiet. Amen. I think that when they want to escape from not saying much and doing much, they run over that side. And they just sit down and look. Amen, everybody? Praise God. But I just want to say thank you. Praise God. We have Pastor Jones coming in. Praise God. Just now, God bless you. Praise God. Amen. Praise God, praise God. And I just want to say to us quickly, praise God, thank you for everyone who have participated, praise God, throughout this weekend. it has been a success. Amen. Praise God. And we still have a little more way to go. Amen. Because I know that God is about to move mightily in this place. And you did not leave your place of worship tonight just to come here and sit down, but you are here to help us to worship in the beauty of holiness. So I want to take time out to thank all the pastors, praise God, from your respective place of worship. I want to take time out to thank you, praise God, for joining us tonight and on Friday night and Saturday night. What a night last night. Praise God. What a night last night. Amen. As the preacher says, step into the fire. Glory to God, and we see people step into the fire. Amen. Praise God. Wonderful time we had. I just want to say thank you to our able secretary. She's always doing such great job. Amen. Praise God. Put your hands together for our secretary evangelist, Marcin Cohen. Praise God on her team. Praise God. Praise God. I know that she is still working as I'm speaking. Amen. I just want to thank God also for the different praise teams coming in from the different assemblies. Amen. Put your hands together for the praise teams. I think that they have done well and still doing well. Amen. Praise God. And we just want to say thank you very much. You had a flavor, praise God, to the service. Sounded well. Praise God, each night getting better and better. Amen. Praise God. I just want to say a special thank you also for those persons who have hosted the saints coming from the different places. Praise God. And I want you, especially those who have been placed in your respective places. I know at the beginning there were some hiccups, but we always have that. But nevertheless, we were able to overcome. Amen. Put your hands together for those persons who opened their houses. Praise God. And allow us to praise God, be a part of it. You know, one of the things, especially now in this COVID time, I know that it is a scary thing to even let in people into your house. But nevertheless, these persons, they have opened up their homes, their heart, and have shared their love with us. Amen. And their space. And we just want to say thank you very much. Praise God. I want to thank God also for the different speakers. Amen. They have done well. And I want to actually point out the speaker for Friday in the day. That young lady. What's her name again? Sister? Oh, yes, you should smile. She did a wonderful job. Praise God. She did well. I really enjoyed it. Amen. She did well with her small voice and small body. Amen. She did well, and I thank God, praise God for you. Keep on holding on. And I just want to say the preachers, they have done well. Amen. Praise God, and you are yet to hear more. Amen, because we are not through yet. Amen. Praise God. I want to say thanks especially to all the workers here. We have some great brothers here in Buckner. And we have some great sisters in Buckner. You have done well. Amen. You have done well. And I need to say more on that even Sunday coming. Amen. Because what I have to say, it will take up a whole lot of time right now. But I just want to thank you. Amen. You know that physically, I could not have done it. So they have chipped in and they have done well. And I am asking you, brethren, put your hands together for them. They have made it happen. Praise God. And for those that serving also in the tuck shop, amen. You are seeing a young man in the tuck shop also, Brother Ferdy. Praise God. He's an all-rounder. Amen. Praise God. He's an all-rounder. And we need to pray for him. Amen. We need to pray for him. Praise God. I want to thank God also for our plumber came in and saved the day, because we had some problem with the plumbing. At the last part, we found out we had some problem. But Mr. Paul O'Connor stepped in late in the night, praise God, and sort out things for us. And we want to say thank you. Also, our electrician, praise God, Mr. Carl, amen. Praise God. We want to say thank you very much. Praise God. And I must say a big thanks to Mr. Brother Ryan. I'm stressing, honestly. Over there at the keyboard. He's stressing to me, amen? But him helped me out a whole lot, amen? We had some real big problem. Yes, I can say that about Ryan. He can't do me nothing. Him always tell me, say, I come from Canaanites, but me come from Buckner. Praise God. But he has done well. They spend a whole lot of time here to make sure that the music is sounding good. Amen. Put your hands together for him one more time. Praise God. And I must say thank you to our community members. If you notice down the road that they are having a big thing going on. But I let them know that we're having convocation going on here. So anything that they're having down there, they have to keep it down, that it doesn't disturb us up here. You know, the beauty about it is that the person promoted, they came to me. They came to my wife. I was not there. And so we're going to have something down there. But we explained that we're having convocation. Amen? And he said, Pastor, you know, it's out of respect that I come to you. And I said, I'm happy for that. But remember, we're having church. Amen? And I'm quite sure that they didn't disturb you much up here. Because when them go, if you go get bad in a man, they make nice in a. Amen, everybody? But I want to say thanks to all the community members. I'm quite sure those from Montego Bay, Westmoreland, everywhere, you feel safe in Buckner, don't it? Yeah, we make people feel safe in Buckner. Yeah, we are good at that. Amen? Anybody come in Buckner, you feel safe because we are here. Amen? And that sound like an accord, man. Anything do anyone on our persona make you look like an Sega? We will make you feel safe. Amen, everybody? Yes. Praise God. And I just want to say thank you, all the brethren, all the different persons from their respective places. Put your hands together for yourself. If you were not here, it could never be a national youth convocation. And I know that we still have a little bit of scare due to the COVID thing, but nevertheless, we have done it one more time. Amen? And the songwriter said, we are together again, just praising the Lord. We are together again on one accord. And believe you me, with all my heart, I believe that something good tonight, something good is going to happen. And I'm just going to allow those ministers who are coming here for the first time to testify, amen, because we want to hear the word of God. So I'm going to be starting off with Deacon, praise God, after which Pastor McNeil, praise God. Then after which, Pastor Jones, in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. You know, sit there and to tell you the truth, there is three persons inside of here that me really, me sit down and me admire the three persons. Before me give testimony, me say this. She, the youth here in the blue shirt, and this gentleman in the green shirt, I really admire those three persons. And guess why? You see, the community where me come from, which is Rocky Point, have a lot of youths. Same age as you, and I can tell you, there is not one. And when I sit down there, so I see the children just there, so I said, just look at that. If all youths just have the mindset like you three, and you are still going to school, right? Now let me say this to you. Persons are going to mock you. Persons are going to mock you, but I have a scripture for you to always remember when they are saying to you, where is your God? Because they are going to say to you that from youth days, they hear that God is coming and there is no God. But 2 Peter 3 and verse 8, always remember, 1,000 years to mankind is like a day to the Lord. So persons are saying from their youth days, they hear the one message over and over and over and over. God is coming. One day, my son, my daughter, he's going to appear. Keep on doing what you're doing. Now, for the adults, I've sit there and also realized that when it's testimony time, it seems as if persons, if they don't have a competitive testimony, they don't want to say it. Testimony is not about competitive. The Lord God has wake you up this morning. That's a testimony. If your testimony is not that hot, for the crowd, stand up, you don't want to say it. Stop my pride killing you. The Lord has wake you up this morning. When it comes to testimony, you are looking around to see who is testify and hearing what person is saying. Stop judging by a double standard and testify of the goodness that the Lord has done for you. Now, my testimony. Everybody must know the journey from Rocky Fine to Mobie. And me have a look at one bike, 150. And my ride from Rocky Pine go straight to Mobie. I left from in the evening, I reach about 9 o'clock in the night. I'm going to say, I'm nasty at Mobie because I'm going to start out on the 150 bike, you know. I'm going to show you how good God is. The same time, the bike no rest, the engine no rest, me left back from Mobie the same night, come back at Rocky Pine. Now I park. And the next morning, early, I get up, say, I go somewhere. I'm right from Bo, Yasso. Go right at the church door. And the chain fly off. And I'm like, thank you, Father God. Suppose that day I'm somewhere down, poor outside for me in the night. Oh, that man is through Alan Bambo. The Lord God say, hey, my son, you are going where you are going, and you are coming back. And then the next day, I will let the chain bust right in your area. God is good all the time. And all the time, thank you, Lord God Almighty.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise Him again. Lift your hand and worship God. Praise God. God is good. I put you in front of my melody. You're all that matters. You are all that matters. I make room for two. Jesus, you are all that matters. You are all that matters. I put you in front of my melody.
You are all.
In front of my melody, you are all. Somebody call on the great God of heaven. Somebody give him praise in this house. Somebody worship Jesus in this house. Somebody worship Jesus in this house. Somebody worship Jesus in this house. Somebody worship Jesus. Somebody worship.
You are all.
Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Somebody worship. Somebody worship.
Because of my melody.
Yeah.
and be seated. I'm pleased to appreciate the presence of the Lord, the powerful presence of the Lord.
Hey, hallelujah! Hey, Lord Jesus.
David said, "The Lord is." And we can't beat that. We just can't beat that. The Lord is. He's right here. He's right in this house. He's our healer. He's our deliverer. When troubles in our lives, if we can praise him, he will take control. I greet the Rastam Associates. Glad to see you all. Amen. Some of my friends. Praise God. Minister White. Amen. Praise God. The meeting couldn't end and we don't come. Pastor, glad to see you, sir. Glad to see you. God bless you. Glad to have some of our ministers and saints in the house. My wife is somewhere there as well. Amen. This is the first time in this house. Well, I came here before, but not for service. Amen. But I'm glad to be in the service, and I really happy to see what is happening here. Praise the name of the Lord. God is moving by his spirit. God is in control. I said to the brethren today that if the prophecies that is prophesied over my life, amen, they are right, me can't dead now. Nothing can kill me. I don't know about you, you know, but if the prophecies that is prophesied over my life, nothing can kill me. It no matter how the enemy pronounce sickness and death, Pastor, you can't dead if God no says so. Amen. Somebody say can't dead. Amen. Somebody say can't dead. Amen. Somebody say can't dead. Amen. Y'all go tired fisting me face. Enough people want to kill you, you know.
Yes.
Because we attack truth. Yes. And that type of problem. Yes. So then while we're out of the way, yes, so them can do what they want to. Amen. But if the prophecies are true, yes, me can't dead. Yes. No, right now. Me can't dead right now. Yes. So me not afraid of nobody. Yes. I'm not afraid of nothing. Yes. Because me can't dead before the time.
All right.
God bless you as we continue to press forward to the mark for the price of the higher calling. We will reset, we will connect, because we are going to rebuild the apostolic, powerful, divine movements again.
Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. You know, I sat here and I was just looking in the congregation. And I said, you know, I want to see that day when we don't have any Christ gospel. I know Bethel. I know this. We're just being God's people. Worship God. Anybody agree with me? Anybody agree with me? Where we move all the labors, come together and say one church. And it is the church of Jesus Christ. Good God, good God, good God. God bless you, Pastor Miles. God bless you, sir. Praise God. Praise God. We want to hear from Minister Hughes. Praise God. And Evangelist Douglas. Praise God in Jesus' name. And while you're coming, I realize I have it on my list, but I can't. Oh, because after we eat so much food, so much pork, and all them Sunday, we leave out the kitchen staff. We can't do that. We can never do that. Put your hands together for the kitchen staff. They have done well. Am I right? Am I right? You said the pork eater should be shouting, yeah, you know. Because the pork really tastes nice. Amen? God bless you all. Minister Hughes in Jesus' name.
Thank you so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, bless the Lord. If you feel it in your spirit to say thank you, Jesus, somebody just go ahead and let the devil know that you're here today. Somebody just say hallelujah. Somebody disappoint the adversary and say hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I must first of all greet all the wonderful men and women of God, all protocol observe, hallelujah to God. This man that you're seeing here, you call him Elder Stewart. I say Elder Delroy Stewart, hallelujah to God. And I told him that, you know, you don't have a little boy name, because ain't no kids around now that we're going to call them Delroy, hallelujah. So you know he's a big man. Bless the name of Jesus Christ. And so he's my friend, and I bring you greetings on behalf of my mother, Mother Hughes, bless the name of Jesus Christ. And I just want to say to the church here in Buckner, there's something special about Buckner. I don't know if I get myself in trouble by saying this, but you just feel original. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, it's original time. Somebody just tell your neighbor, it's original time. Or somebody talk about reset. Somebody talk about reset. I want to say to somebody, you can't reset nothing unless it is original. Or somebody say original. Or somebody say original. Oh, hallelujah. I'm just going to use a 2 minute here to tell somebody today, hallelujah to God, that we realize that resetting, reconnecting, and rebuilding has been used all for a couple of days. Hallelujah. Everybody by now should know the meaning. Hallelujah to God. But I want to say something to somebody. Glory to God. That when we gather in this fashion, we gather as union. Hallelujah to God. Iron sharpened iron. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah to God. When you leave your home and you get here, all the different Holy Ghosts that is in the different churches, we bring the one Jesus Holy Ghost here. And we pray for something to happen. Oh, somebody worship God in the house. I sat in the audience. Glory to God. I might look young, but I'm pretty old. Glory to God. I sat in the audience and I was looking at the elders. Magnifying God. Come on, somebody. I was looking at all the elders magnifying God, and I was trying to count how many young persons are in church tonight. You see, I work around teenagers. Bless the name of Jesus Christ. And I know that the world is in trouble. Tell your neighbor, we are in trouble. Hallelujah to God. Because when these folks pass, who is going to carry on the gospel? Oh, somebody say hallelujah. Oh, somebody just stretch forth your hand to a child right now and pronounce original upon them. Oh, somebody say reset in Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah. If you realize I come from a community where scamming has taken over the minds of every young man in the community. Can we talk church? Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. can we let go a hallelujah for somebody that has been banned by scamming? Oh, somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. I feel like I want to just say to somebody, let me leave the podium. Glory to God. I just want to say to somebody tonight, feel good in yourself right now. But somebody out there is suffering. Come on, somebody. Somebody out there is suffering. I feel like I want to use a jumper cable faith right now to unleash in Buckner those souls who are suffering in Cave, in Lionel Town, in all the different communities. Persons who are suffering from depression. Persons who are suffering from stress. Persons who are suffering from no hope. Somebody unleash the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Rescue the perishing, care for the dying. Or somebody just get up on your feet and say, in the name of Jesus. Somebody say, in the name of Jesus. Oh, somebody say, in the name. Somebody say, in the name. Listen, good piece here. Because somebody here came. And you left your home. Give me 1 minute. Somebody left your home as Abraham. Somebody walked out as Abraham. And I'm sending you back to your community as Abraham. Come on, somebody. Turn to your neighbor. Neighbor, you look at me right now. I'm under construction. Come on, tell somebody. Neighbor, you look at me right now. I'm under construction. I'm not the beautiful image that you're going to see later on. But when I leave this convocation, I might just sell out. But when I leave here, God is going to give me something special. Oh, Shatalabasa. I want you to use declaration right now. Come on, somebody. You're going to talk with me. Go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you, and I will make of you a great nation. I will bless you, and I will make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and him who dishonor you, I will curse. Say after me, I will bless you. Everybody, send it back home to your community. All those little persons you see walk, hallelujah, in your spirit. You know them who walk daily down the street, up the street, hallelujah, have no sense of direction. Ah, you are okay because you are at the source. Come on, somebody. But they have no hope. They are walking like zombies. They are not sure if they are going or they are coming. But we are sending out a rescue boat to rescue the perishing. Oh, somebody say rescue. Rescue. Oh, hallelujah. If I can help somebody as I travel on, then my living. God bless you. Rescue somebody if you can. That's what Christ's gospel. Thank you, my friend. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah, somebody. What kind of church is this? What kind of church is this? My God, I love what I feel. And I feel what I love. Hallelujah, somebody. I love the whole time church. Hallelujah, church. I just want to greet my friend, Pastor Stewart. My friend and brother. Many years. And I just want to greet the rostrum. Amen. God bless you. And my one wife. My God, if you're married 2 times, you're in trouble. One wife. Hallelujah, somebody. Whenever you have a phone, and your phone starts in trouble, you go in our settings. Right? And then you see factory reset. So when you press factory reset now, the phone reset. Hallelujah, somebody. And when you want it to connect back to the Wi-Fi, you get the Wi-Fi password and reconnect it. So whenever you feel like you have trouble in a church, go back to factory reset, man. The Bible is a factory reset. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah, somebody. Reset and reconnect back to Jesus. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Glory. Somebody shout glory. Glory. Somebody shout glory. Glory. There's a word in the house. Anybody believe that?
Yes.
There's a word in the house. And it's coming at us. Amen? To change our heart. To fix us right. Praise God. But just before the preacher, we're going to be asking Pastor Howie to sing in Jesus' name.
Somebody just give the Lord a praise. Bless the name of Jesus, everybody. Bless the name of Jesus, everybody. Praise the name of Jesus. In a time such as this, Ekoshaya, hey, hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. Hey, hallelujah. Some people don't pray like they used to pray. Way back in God. Some people don't pray like they used to pray. Way back in God. Some people don't pray like they used to pray. Way back in God. Some people don't pray like they used to pray. Oh, way back in God. So let's go way.
Sing like they used to sing.
Way back in.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Glory. Yeah. Glory. People don't even worship like how they used to worship.
Hallelujah.
We're back
Hallelujah.
In God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I remember when I was younger, just got the Holy Ghost. And remain standing, the preacher's coming now. I'm not going to be long. And I went to this particular church in Maypen. My brother and I just got the Holy Ghost. Hot. God Almighty. And when we started dancing in the church, one young lady came over to me and said, "Members, your church are there." Full of fire.
Yes, sir.
These young people nowadays, they look like everybody have arthritis. Can't even rock. Can't even clap. Look, if you just suppose our young people, them sit down. And just a look. As them rock two times, then tired. Can't worship like how we used to worship. We're back in God. Brother Malcolm, as them stand up two times, them sit down before the older one, them long time. Them tired. Poor thing, them. Everybody stand in the house. Just lift up your right hands to God. You see, why I always do that is that, listen, this is the time when the devil works the most. He doesn't want you to hear a word. This is the moment that some people want to go to the bathroom, that them ready to go home, and all different type of things. They don't want to hear the word. But as you lift your hands, just say the blood of Jesus. We are chasing the devil out of this atmosphere. Come on, man. Spit some blood in this place. And said, "The blood ekosha, the blood of Jesus, because there is a word for me." Come on, man. Come on. Come on. Anybody believe that? There is a word for me. And tonight, to share the word of God with us, a young man, an anointing brother, praise God, very excited about preaching. Praise God and sharing the word of God.
And tonight, we are placing him in the hands of the Holy Ghost. Because we want to hear from God through him, good God Almighty. And at this time, glory to God, coming out of the Rumble Upon Christ Gospel Apostolic Church, I present to you Overseer Bernard Summon in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Can we just love the Lord one more time? Can we just love the Lord one more time? Hallelujah. Somebody bow your heads with me in the house of the Lord. Oh Lord, our help in ages past, and our hope for years to come. Our shelter from the stormy blast. God, you are our eternal hope. We look to you, God, for an anointing that makes preaching easy. We look to you, God, for the right word that heals heart, brings deliverance, healing, and miracles of all sorts that will penetrate the heart and bring victory. Transform those, God, who needs to be lifted higher. Magnify those, God, who the enemy allowed to feel insignificant. Do wonders among the company of the people at the works of your hands. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. We ask tonight that you stop the hands of the enemy. Oh, glory to God, and prove yourself again to your people. Amen. That you are great and mighty. In Jesus' name, amen. Somebody praise God with me. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Amen. Praise God. I'm going to have to be doing some time management. Praise God. Amen. So while you're still standing, turn your Bibles with me to Ezekiel chapter 37. Ezekiel chapter 37. Glory to God. Amen. We would read from verse 1. Seven. One to seven. Amen. And then we will just do 37. 3, 7. 1 to 7. Amen. Praise God. And then we will read verse 13 and 14. Amen. Are we there tonight? Amen. Praise God. The hand of the Lord was upon me, and he carried me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, they were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. And again he said unto me, prophesy unto these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and ye shall live. And I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and ye shall live, and ye shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as was commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking, and the bones came together, bones to his bones. 13 and 14, and ye shall know that I am the Lord when I have opened your graves, O my people, and brought you up out of your graves, and shall put my spirit in you, and ye shall live, and I shall place you in your own land. Then shall ye know that I, the Lord, have spoken it and performed it, saith the Lord. Praise God. Would you be kind, amen, tonight, to just open your mouth before you take your seat. Glory to God, amen. And kindly, amen, praise God, command, amen, the person who is right beside you, amen, and tell them, reconnect for greatness. Praise God, amen. That's a command. Somebody hit the command button. Praise God, amen. Tell them, reconnect for greatness. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Let me honor the Lord God for being good to us. Truly his mercies endure it forever. We honor him in his majesty and his power. For he is a holy God. Beside him, there's absolutely no other. Amen. Because he is the head of life. He is the giver of life. He is the lifter of our head. And we glorify the Lord. Let me hasten to greet Overseer Stewart, all the great men of God on the platform, pastors, ministers, youth presidents, amen. This great congregation, amen, that comes together to make this youth convention, glory to God, amen, a very great one. I greet you tonight in the awesome name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let me, amen, praise God. Start out by saying praise God, that I really want at least 5 person, amen, praise God, to just help me swing this word through. Amen. With your prayers that we can get out of here in 20 minutes. Are you with me? Praise the Lord. Can I get 5 person to covenant with me that you'll preach with me for 20 minutes? Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Every time we look at the scripture, we get a glimpse of 2 things. We get a glimpse of gloominess and hope. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. And so I challenge you that from verse 1 to verse 10 is a vision that the Lord carried the prophet into the spirit so that he could get a better view of the current situation Israel was in as a nation. Anybody here with me? Praise God. We look in the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and it's the only place we had seen where Jesus, amen, used parables, amen, praise God, amen, to bring across his message, amen, praise God, like he did with Ezekiel in chapter 37. By the time he gets to verse 11 to 15, he is no longer dealing, amen, praise God, with the prophet on the level of a vision. But now he's dealing with the prophets, amen, explaining to him, glory to God, amen, the secret of the vision and what's in his heart for the people. Somebody glorify God with me in here. Praise God. And so Ezekiel had to go up in the spirit, amen, as glory to God, the Lord asked him to, so he could get a proper look, a proper view, glory to God, of where the people was as a nation. Disconnected. Somebody help me in here. Glory to God. Amen. Hopeless. Disengage, praise God, amen. Lack of loyalty and commitment, praise God, amen. And as a result, the best version of the people could not come forward. Somebody help me in here, glory to God. And so God presented the situation in the vision form to the prophet, amen. Hallelujah. And he referred the children of Israel, praise God, as dry bones. Somebody glorify God with me in here, praise God. Amen. The situation here gets a little bit more as it expands. Amen. Praise God. Amen. The writer refers to, amen, glory to God, this valley as a place of death, the valley of death. And now, praise God, the perspective from which, amen, God wanted the prophet to see these people, amen, praise God, was that they were in an open place and they were surrounded with hopelessness. Somebody tell the devil, you are a liar tonight. Glory to God. I may be in an environment that does not, glory to God, contribute to where God wants me to go. Oh, glory to God. But as soon as I get a better look at where God wants to take me, then everything gets ready to change. Somebody help me. Somebody help me preaching here. Glory to God. So I want you to open your mouth right where you are and speak to yourself. Glory to God. And I want you to tell yourself, I'm anticipating that change. Somebody preach with me in here tonight. That change that's going to bring greatness. I am anticipating that change. Somebody help me preach in here. Oh, glory to God. And now the situation that they were in, amen, the prophet presented it, glory to God, that the kind of help that Israel needed, oh, glory to God, was nothing carnal man could have done to the situation. He left the people in his presentation dry, amen, without flesh, without life. Glory to God, amen. And the situation was next to impossible, glory to God, to come back to. Somebody help me in here. Glory to God. God, and then the Lord asked the prophet a question. And he said, the state that I show you these people in, I want to get real personal with you. As a priest that traveled, amen, that came into, amen, praise God, office as a prophet in exile, in prison, in a state whereas you are shaky. Oh, glory to God. By all the environment and the things around you, oh God, that says memories back home, the time past may never return. So I want to ask you the question, based on your environment, based and the things that up against you, can these bones live? Somebody help me up in here tonight. I'm feeling as if I'm getting ready to close this word. Somebody ask your neighbor this question. Can these dry bones live? What was the dry bone? It was the children of Israel. Their life's condition, the promises dried up, disengaged, not in a good and active relationship with God, and the gap between them and their maker was so far apart, and the devil seemed as if this was now what he was about to rejoice over. But not because I'm at my lowest. It doesn't say God ain't gonna do anything about it. Not because I've gone so far from my original place. It doesn't mean God is gonna do anything about it. I come to remind you that God promised my father Abraham that he was going to make his name great, and a portion of the prophecy now hangs with this generation that is in no position to look like a blessing. Somebody help me get out of here tonight. Can I find my five people now? Somebody glorify God. And it looks real bad, but if God called a prophet, it's not as bad as it looks. Because every time a prophet takes a position over a situation, something is about to change. Somebody high five your neighbor. Tell him something is about to change. Somebody come to church with me tonight. I don't care how you got here. I don't care what held you back before you got here.
I don't care what you've been going through. I don't care what the devil told you. The prophet is positioned to speak over my situation. Somebody tell your neighbor one more time. I'm about to open my mouth and I'm about to bless you. Somebody preach with me in here. Can I find somebody over there? Just lay your hands on somebody and tell him, I'm about to bless you. Somebody glorify God with me. Somebody help me preach in here. I don't need to know when your healing is going to come. It's not my prerogative. I was only called to prophesy. I don't need to know when your deliverance is going to come. I was only called to prophesy. Oh, Lord Jesus. So I got to ask the question. Lord, 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 thou knowest. I got to answer the question, rather. Thou knowest. Somebody help me preach in here. It now gives an indication that how deteriorated the people were. It was only God who had the answer to how far down these people had gone. Somebody help me preach in here. They had gone so far down that they were the laughing stock to the nations around them. Everybody called them the reject, subjected to Babylon, lost their names. They were classified as eunuchs. Their ability to give life was taken. Their potency was taken. Names changed. Identity changed. Full-blown Babylonian. But in all of this, God showed up. Somebody help me close out this word. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. I may be as close as hell, but God knows where hell is. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. And when God speaks, his voice goes to the uttermost part of the world. He shook the grave. He delivered the dead from the grave. And if God can do that, then my position is about to change. Somebody hold your neighbor's hand and tell him, my position is about to change. Oh, come on, preach it, my son. I got about 5 more minutes left. Somebody preach it me over there. Timely grab somebody and tell him, my position is about to change. Somebody help me preach in here. If God asked the question, he expected an answer. Somebody glorify God in here. So I'll ask you again, do you believe God can bring somebody back from their lost state? Can I get some answers in here? Do you believe God can heal you from your sicknesses and your diseases? Do you believe God can raise you up from your slumber? Somebody help me preach in here. Somebody glorify God. And I want to just get it higher and close. Somebody glorify God. Ezekiel couldn't say anything because he knew that when you present a nation, God Almighty, as dry bones, you're simply saying it's a disgrace to you, God. Because these people had died and never had a proper burial, and their bones are left exposed to the enemy as a reminder that I had the first victory. Somebody open your mouth. Say, enemy, you may have had the first victory, but prophecy is about to come forth. Somebody open your mouth. Say, enemy, you laugh last, but you laugh first, but I'm gonna laugh last, because no weapon that form against me shall prosper. I feel my preaching here, and every tongue that rise up against me shall condemn. Somebody open your mouth. Somebody say, neighbor,
I shall not die. I got prophecy over my life. I shall not die. I got the word of God over my life. Somebody shout, I shall. Hallelujah. Somebody shout again, I.
It may have looked like a disgrace, the state I'm in. Looked so bad that everybody else wrote me off. But just when you think it's not good and can't get better, there's a word from God. I'm counting down my time. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. And the Bible said that the Lord said to the prophet, I know you have seen the condition of my people, but I want you to open your mouth and I want you to prophesy. Somebody get up in here with me. Somebody help me preach in here. I want you to find somebody and I want you to tell them the Holy Ghost is about to unlock some things in your life. Somebody help me preach in here. Unless it's unlocked, greatness can't come. Some things that bound up, some things the devil said never would come to life, the Holy Ghost is about to unlock. Somebody say, Holy Ghost, fly me open. Jesus, can I get some real people to help me close out this word? Somebody praise God in here. Somebody praise God. I'll prophesy over these dry bones. Somebody help me preach in here. Glory to God. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Now please listen to me as I close. Everything God wanted to reassemble the people were currently underground. Somebody help me up in here. They were bones, but they were in place. They were underground, scattered all over, but they were underground. I don't know how much the bits and pieces of your life may have been scattered all over, but get ready to prophesy over your scattered pieces, because as long as you're scattered, God can grant greatness to your life. As long as you're scattered, greatness won't come. Stand up with me over there, please. I'm counting down. As long as you're scattered, you can't be mighty. As long as you're not unified, you can't get that connection that you need with God to be superior. Somebody say, neighbor, I'm about to reconnect. Yeah, God, somebody. Yeah. Somebody help me praise God in here. I got my bones all over, but I'm ready to reconnect. Can I see somebody in here who feels this anointing that's about to put you back in your authority? Somebody help me preach in here. Glory to God. And the Bible would have us to understand that Ezekiel opened his mouth and he prophesied to the bones, and he never said, hear the prophet. He said, hear the word of the Lord. What the word says, you may be scattered, but you shall not die.
You may not have it together, but you shall not die. Don't got no money, but you're not broke. Not feeling good, but your healing is coming. Weeping, crying, mourning. Weeping may endure for a night, but your joy.
My joy is coming. Somebody open your mouth and say, I got an announcement. Somebody say, neighbor, I have an announcement. My joy is coming. For all the hell I've been through, my joy. Old Jai Bones. Old Jai Bones. Hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord to these bones. Now some of you may say, you are not the voice of God. But hear what the prophet says. This is the voice of the Lord speaking to these bones. Some of you may be saying, you're just my brother in Christ. But you're the vessel God is using to declare somebody unlocked in the presence of God. Somebody tell a neighbor, listen to me. I'm about to prophesy. Somebody help me preach in here. Before I close, let me tell you the power of your voice. Let me tell you the power of your voice. I know church continue to remain to love to be silent. But let me tell you the power of your voice. Every time God puts a word in your spirit to speak to somebody, Almighty God, that word is like a 1,000 bulldozer getting ready to buck down any mountain that stands between the word and the messenger. Somebody missed it. So when the prophet prophesied, a couple of things happened. Every spirit that hanged over the nation's ability to please God start disappearing. Somebody open your mouth again in here. I said, neighbor, I'm going to speak in your life. Then the Holy Ghost is going to come and back up the spoken word. Oh God, I feel like closing out here right now. So you better be ready for what I gotta tell you. The devil wants you dead, but I prophesy life. Somebody help me clear it in here. The devil wants you dry. Yeah. But God said your time has not yet come. Somebody open your mouth. Say purpose is on you. Destiny is waiting. You can't die till you get there. Preach, come on, open your mouth. Tell them you can't die until you get there. You can't die until you accomplish. You can't die until you finish what God puts in your belly. Somebody open your mouth. Somebody shout, purpose, come alive. Purpose, somebody open your mouth. Purpose, come alive. The word went forth first and commanded the bones. The word of life went forth and commanded the bones. And after he prophesied, he said, I got one more declaration. I'm going to cause the wind. Somebody said the wind. Almighty God, to blow on you. God. And it says, surely God is going to breathe to you, into you, and you shall live. Somebody said, neighbor, your hope is renewed. Lord God, let me just read this last verse and close. Can I speak to the folks whose anointing had dried up? Can I speak to the folks who had lost their purpose and their calling? The prophet says, as the Lord said, I will put sinews on you. I will bring your flesh. Oh God, I'll cause your flesh to come upon you. I'll cause you to be covered with skin. Somebody help me preach in here. I want you to tell your neighbor, I'm not done. I'm just under construction. Somebody help me preach in here. I'm closing out this word. Somebody hold on to somebody. Tell him, keep the dream alive. I'm just under construction. Somebody help me shout out. It's not over yet. This is not the end. Somebody help me preach. Somebody help me preach.
Hallelujah.
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 Yeah. Cause flesh to come upon you so that everybody around you will see that life came again. Somebody help me preach. Somebody said life is here again. Lord God Almighty, somebody help me close out this word. Somebody shout, life. Somebody lay hands, somebody. Tell him life. Find somebody else. Tell him life.
Life.
And when the Spirit came, the Bible said, scattered bones reassembled. Somebody help me preaching here. Scattered bones reconnected. Somebody help me preaching here. So I feel some scattering stuff coming together right now. Well, the Bible said, bones to bones. Somebody help me preach in here. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. And then the Bible said, hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Hallelujah. That the wind came after the Lord breathed on the people. A wind came from the north and the wind came from the south. Somebody said, the wind is the Holy Ghost. Somebody preach with me. The wind came. Somebody preach with me. Hallelujah. What was the wind? The breath of God. Somebody open your mouth. Say, Lord, like you're breathing Adam, breathe in me. Make me a living soul. Somebody say, breathe on me. Can I get somebody over there? Open your mouth aloud. Say, Holy Ghost, breathe on me. Breathe off death. Breathe off hopelessness. Breathe life.
I gotta close.
I will cause the wind to come from the four corners of the world and give you back your life. My last two verses and I close. now that I breathe on you and life had returned, I can't keep you in the grave. Somebody help me preach. Somebody said the grave is not my place. Come on, somebody help me close out this word. Somebody grab somebody and tell him the grave. I feel like I'm dead. Somebody glorify God in here. Somebody shout the grave.
The grave
is not my place. I've got too much greatness in me to be in the grave. Somebody help me preach in here. Somebody glorify God with me. Somebody lift up your hands one more time. I said, I've got too much greatness to be in the grave. Yeah. So God said, here is the final piece of the puzzle. The grave that you were in. Somebody said, the grave. The grave that you were in. I'm going to burst the grave. Somebody tell a neighbor, get ready to come out. Come out of your grave. Now that I breathe on you, come out of that grave. It was designed to hold you back. It was designed to stop you. It was designed to cripple you from destiny. But the devil is a liar. Just like on the resurrection morning, the power of the Holy Ghost shake the dead from the grave. Blast the grave open. Said Israel, my people, come out of the grave. Somebody hold somebody. Tell him in the name of Jesus, I command you, come out of the grave. Somebody help me up here. Somebody's too quiet. Find somebody else. Tell him, I command you, come out of your grave. You're not dead anymore. Say, you're not dead anymore. Come out. Come out. Come out of your grave. Start walking in greatness. Somebody step it out. Somebody said, greatness, here I come. Purpose, here I come. Destiny, here I come. Calling, here I come. Power, come upon me. Take me into my destiny. Somebody open your mouth. Prophesy up from the grave. Arise. Come with me, come with me. Up from the grave. Up from the grave. Up from the grave. I'm calling out to Lazarus right now. Up from the grave. Somebody help me in here. For the last time, hold somebody's hand. Tell him in the name of Jesus, I command you to reconnect. You're not dead anymore. Reconnect with your purpose. Everything God said you are, you're going to become it. Somebody say everything. Everything. Somebody shout everything. Somebody say everything. I gotta close. I gotta close. For the last time, I want you to hold somebody with every energy that you have. And I want you to tell them, I look at you. Oh, come on, honey, help me talk. And I see greatness.
Oh, come on, somebody, come on. Somebody's voice is not going anywhere in here. I want some. Where are my five people? Where are my five people? Grab somebody. Tell him, I look at you and I see greatness. Sorry, but I can't leave you in the grave. Somebody help me. Yeah, I got to pull you out by the neck, by the collar, by the finger. I'm pulling. Somebody help me here. Ain't nobody dying. Ain't nobody dying. Somebody help me up in here. I feel the Holy Ghost. I feel the breath of God. Hey, somebody shout, yes, Lord. I can't leave you in the grave. Help me preach. Help me. Prophesy to your pastor. Prophesy to your friend. Tell him, I can't leave you. Purpose was not designed to die. Destiny's calling. I can't leave you in the grave. So I got to have this anointing. Because I was destined to lay hands on the sick and they recovered. Somebody say, neighbor, destiny is on you. Come on, church, you're too silent in here. Somebody grab somebody and tell him, destiny is on you. I command the Holy Ghost to unlock your destiny. Every dead thing's in your belly, unlock. Somebody say, unlock. Prophesy. Come on, open your mouth. Every curse, every generational curse, every sickness in your body, unlock healing. Somebody say, yes. Yes. I unlock you. I unlock you. Come here. Come here. Change position with your birth partner. Change position. Change position. Put your hands in your neighbor's back. Come on, somebody get it in here. Spirit of obedience, come upon this house. Somebody said, now that I got you out of the grave, I feel the Holy Ghost in here. I'm about to push you into destiny. Somebody said, I know you resisted this a long time ago, but I'm pushing you. Yeah, I'm pushing you in your place. I'm pushing you in your calling. I'm pushing you into greatness. One more push. One more push. One. Somebody push. Push. Somebody push. Somebody push. Somebody push. Somebody push. Somebody push. Empty, and I am available
to you.
To you. Somebody just got there.
Lord, to you.
My will.
I'll do what you say.
empty, Lord.
I am
available to you.
Everybody, one more time.
Lord, I'm available to you.
Yes, 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 yes.
My will I give to you. I'll do what you say. Use me, Lord,
to show someone the way. And enable me to say, my spirit is empty. I am.
And I am available to you.
Hallelujah. 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 We want to reset it tonight. We want to reset. I'm going to call for the mothers in Zion. The mothers in Zion. We want to get back to the whole time church when the mothers in Zion were willing to tarry to see that one come through. Can I call for some mothers in Zion? Hallelujah. Those who know how to work at the altar. Can I call for some more tonight? Can I call for some more tonight? Don't walk out. Just give us a few minutes. Just give us a few minutes. Hallelujah.
Said, I'm giving back to you all those tools you gave to me.
My hands, my ears, my voice, my eyes, so you can use them as you
please.
I am giving up.
Available to you.
Oh, Lord.
and I'm available to you.
Hallelujah.
Yes, said I'm giving
back to you
all the tools you gave to me. Somebody needs to empty out tonight. Somebody needs to empty out. 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 Somebody needs to empty out.
Yeah.
Children that are seeking God here. Amen. We need some more people up here to pray with them. Come on, come on. Come on. We need some more people to pray with them. Keto shata yama. Kendo la baba basata yama. Eto yaba basanda. Eko shata. Some more people to pray. We need some more people to pray.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
For he alone is worthy to receive.
of God arise. Son of God arise. From the end of the earth. From the end of the earth. Fire in my heart. Fire in my mouth.
Fire in my feet.
Fire. Fire for the enemy.
I feel it in my heart.
Fire.
I feel it in my body.
Fire.
I feel it in my body.
God don't need no, God don't need no matches.
He's fire by himself.
God don't need no matches.
He's fire by himself.
God don't need no matches.
He's fire by himself. Fire.
Fire.
Fire. Fire.
Fire. Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. You are God. You are great. You are Emmanuel. You are omnipotent. You are omniscient. You are powerful. You are mighty. You are holy. You are the one that creates mankind. And so you create us to worship you. You create us to praise you. You create us to adore you. My God, we are here tonight. And so, Lord Jesus, some of your people had walked to the altar because they need the Holy Ghost. Lord, we pray that you will visit them tonight. Oh, God, you know how to fill them. Lord Jesus, you know how to fill them. My God, we call forth, oh God, filling. Hallelujah, in this house tonight, we call forth filling. Fill the cups, Lord. 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 Jesus, let it overflow. We speak to sicknesses in this house tonight. We pray that sicknesses will dry up. Hallelujah. Sicknesses will dry up tonight. My God, somebody will find out that the cancer is gone. Somebody will find out that the liver problem is gone. Somebody will find out that the lungs problem is gone. Hallelujah. Somebody will find out that the diabetes is gone. My God, Almighty Jesus, we are calling forth, Lord, your miraculous acts. Rest it on your people in the name of Hakushana, in the name of Jesus, Lord, 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 Kanuna, Mama, Mama, Shiloma, Mama, bring deliverance in this place tonight. Bring deliverance in this house. We call for the fresh touch in this place tonight. Fresh touch. We call for the fresh touch in this house. Somebody let go your hands and push them in the air and say, fresh touch, Jesus. Somebody release your hands and push them in the air and say, touch me, Lord. Fresh touch, Jesus. Fresh touch, Jesus. Fresh touch, Jesus. Somebody needs to reset tonight. Somebody say, fresh touch. Somebody fresh touch. I said somebody needs to reset tonight. Somebody just begin to say fresh touch. 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 Hallelujah. Can somebody just connect yourself? Just connect yourself right now. Connect yourself right now. Connect yourself right now. Connect yourself with that fresh touch. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say in Jesus' name. Somebody say in Jesus' name. Somebody point your hand to the altar and say, receive it now. My God. Somebody receive it now. Don't just say the words, but I want it to come from deep within you. Somebody just open up your gates. Hallelujah. With your anointed mouth. With your sanctified mouth. With the mouth of a release. And say, receive it now. Oh, Lord. Send a fire. Just now. Send a fire. Just now. Oh, Lord God Almighty. Right now. Oh, God. Do we have any backslider in here? Do we have any backslider in here? Come right here, backslider. If you have any backslider in here, come right here. Hallelujah. Sometimes it's just a mistake. Sometimes it's just trouble that catch you. My God, but you get messed up. But you need a refilling tonight. Come out here, backslider. Ah, God, 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 God. Ain't no use. The old devil cannot turn me around. Ain't no use. The old devil cannot turn me around. For my mind, hallelujah, is on Jesus tonight. Yeah, 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 yeah. Don't go home without it. Don't go home without it. Your breakthrough, your deliverance, don't go home without it. Ah, we're pulling through somebody. Yeah, we're pulling through somebody. We're pulling through somebody. We're pulling through somebody. Yeah, we're pulling through somebody. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord, oh, Lord, oh, Lord. Oh, Lord, send that power just now. Send a power just now. Send a power just now. Oh Lord, send a power just now. And baptize everyone. Say, oh Lord, send a power. Send a power. Send a power. Oh Lord, send a power. Send a power and baptize everyone. Come on, come on. Oh Lord, send a power. Send a power. We're going on, we're going on, we're going on, we're going on. Send a power. Oh Lord. Send a power and baptize in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh, na, ma, na, ma, shana, ya. Hey, send a power, send a power. Oh, Lord. Send a power just now and baptize everyone. Hold on. Hold on. Open them up. Jesus. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open them up. Oh Satan, mama shundulo bo 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 shoto yo bo. Come on, we loose in this place tonight. Hey, my, 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 hey, send your power, send your power, send your power, send your power, Holy Ghost. Release in this house.
Jesus. Can I worship him again a little more? Jesus. Jesus. Open that mouth, Jesus. It's bubbling in the belly. Come on, Jesus. It's bubbling in the belly. Say, Jesus. And baptize everyone. Oh Lord, send that power. Send that power. Send that power just now. Oh Lord, send that power just now. And baptize everyone. Come out of your grave. 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 Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody just shout hallelujah. Come on, we're about to go. We're about to go. But come on, somebody just shout hallelujah. Come on, church of God, somebody just shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We have come thus far by faith. Good God. I feel like giving somebody else 30 more seconds just to receive the Holy Ghost. Just to speak in tongues as the Spirit of God give utterance. Yes, somebody else. You got 30 more seconds. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Come on, let's bow our heads. Father, we thank you tonight. Oh God, we glorify your name. Oh God, we thank you for the spoken word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh God, we thank you, God, that God, you're a giver of life. Hallelujah. And Father God, we thank you. Oh God, for your move tonight. Hallelujah. 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 We thank you tonight, God. We give you the praise. Hallelujah. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. Oh God, we give you all the praises. Oh God, we pray, God, hallelujah. Oh God, even one more person tonight, Lord, fill them with the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. Even one more, God, hallelujah. I pray by the power of the Holy Ghost that somebody else will receive the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Before we leave this place tonight, in the name of Jesus, it's not by might nor by power. Oh God, but we stand by your Spirit tonight. Oh God, we believe, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh God, you're the same God.
Hallelujah. Yesterday, today, and forever. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray God name it for those. Hallelujah. That, oh God, are going to be turning from us. We pray God that you cover them under your blood. In the name of Jesus. We pray God. Hallelujah. Oh God, you will bring them, oh God. Oh God, safely home. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, somebody just help me just plead the blood of Jesus. Come on, somebody just help me plead the blood of Jesus. Yeah. Yes, the blood, yes, the blood. Cover them under your blood. Cover them under your blood. In the name of Jesus. We're depending on you, God. That not our will, but we pray your will be done. After our own way, we pray. As we tell you thanks, as we give you the glory, ha, ha, hallelujah. As we give you the glory, as we give you the glory, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. As we give you the glory, in the name of Jesus. We give you praise. We give you praise. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his throne, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. In Jesus' name. Somebody just said, in Jesus' name. Come on, let me hear you shout it out. In Jesus' name. I am an apostolic. Somebody shout it out. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Praise God. I just want to thank you all again. Praise God for coming. Praise God. And please, I want you all to travel safe going home. Praise God. And for those who believe that they have been filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost, then I will ask your pastor to confirm that with us. Amen. Praise God. Because there must be signs that follow them. Amen, everybody. Praise God. God bless you. Love you all. And you all reach home safe now. In Jesus' name, just greet somebody and just love somebody as a go. Thank you all for coming once again, and you all can come back next week. Amen. God bless you.
Bye. By way of announcement, there is a gray Honda that is parked. That's JL. I believe it's 8649. We're gonna ask you just to make some room so that the bus can leave. They're going all the way to St. James. Please, glory be to God, just make some room for them. God bless you. God bless you.